not the way I know how to play a game of basketball on a high level. You know, I'm out there to be a game changer, and I didn't make enough game-changing plays.
Were you not aggressive enough?
Just easy to look back and say, wow, I should have did it this way. Well, I should have been more aggressive. I just know I didn't play well. I could have played down the stretch better. I didn't have enough game-changing plays like I know I'm capable of having. Plays where it just shifted the whole game. I don't remember having one of those plays in the finals.
How did that affect you personally?
Probably one of the hardest times of my life. You know, after the finals, I sat in my room for 2 weeks, did absolutely nothing, talked to absolutely nobody.
What'd you learn?
I got to this point by playing this game a certain way. You know, getting back to me loving the game and having fun with the game. I play the game fun and joyful, you know, and I let my game do all the talking, you know, and, you know, I got away from that.
Failure. For you all that don't know, ladies and gentlemen, that was LeBron James, arguably one of the best professional basketball players to ever touch a basketball, talking about his failure. He failed many of times before he succeeded to get his first NBA championship in 2011. At this specific time, he was referring to the seven-game series versus the Dallas Mavericks, where he failed. The reason this was considered a big failure is because he teamed up with two other all-star elite players. Critics, fans, and others felt that he should have created his own legacy and taken the team to the top. One thing I can say is that he did try, and in 2007 against the San Antonio Spurs, where he took his team to the championship, but also failed. In 2010, LeBron James felt that he did all he could do in Cleveland and joined with the Miami Heat, creating a big three, Dwayne Wade, Chris Bosh, and himself, who at the time were all elite players. His first year with the Heat may be his biggest failure of all. That's not winning the championship. One thing we all are afraid of to face in some sort of way is failure. Some have failed in different things in life, such as sports, getting a job, or even getting fired from a job. Some may be even in relationships they really like. Just because you failed a couple of times doesn't make you a complete failure. You have to learn from your mistakes that caused you to fail, get back into your respective laboratory, and put in work. Acknowledging your failure and taking criticism from others are big steps into success. Failure can work to your advantage if you put that block of failure down and use it as a stepping stone. Failure is only permanent when you give up. Don't give up. Be resilient and persevere through. The reward will be much sweeter overcoming failures than it would be to achieve it and not fail at all. Let failure create an opportunity to be great, and don't let greatness put the fear of failure in your spirit.
You looked at it after all these years. It almost seemed like you could see a reflection in it.
I feel like I was glowing. You know, I feel like the reflection of the gold ball had just, you know, just glowing all over my body. It was like I've dreamed about this moment. I was like, oh my God, I don't want to be nowhere else. Right now, I felt like I was in that arena by myself. You know, at that point, when I grabbed the trophy, I felt like everything else around me was just empty. You know, it's a great moment.
So is there anything that you imagined?
When you fall and you fail so many times, you just say, you know, you kind of just look yourself in the mirror and say, well, you know, what are you going to do about it? You know, you have all these other people around you, and yes, it's a team game, and yes, everything, you know, has to fall in place with the team, but what are you going to do to help things become different? You know, and I did that a lot.
Baby, extra bright, I want y'all to see this.